Okay. When it comes to the first few conversations, always present a range when you talk about price. A mistake that a lot of people make is when they present their initial offers, they'll say, I can pay $45,000 or $100,000. They give a specific price. And when you do that, you lose an opportunity. The opportunity that you lose is actually multiple components. Number one, it gives you, if you present a range, it gives you flexibility for future conversations. So if you say, hey, I can pay $40,000 to $45,000, if you need to go to the lower number, the $40,000, because you've looked at and repairs are higher than you anticipated, well, you told that number to the seller. It also prepares a framework of price with the seller. So they know that you could be as low as 40, you could be as high as 45, but they've already built in expectations that the number can be lower. And then the last thing is what you'll notice with more savvy sellers, people that are more knowledgeable about their property, especially investors and people within the real estate space, they'll look at somebody presenting a specific price as a novice or somebody that's newer in the space, because it is very difficult to properly price a property that you're trying to pursue with a very specific price point unless you've seen it and you've run your due diligence. So if you're presenting just a particular price, then you're usually lowballing the person. And if you're dealing with a savvy investor, that's going to hurt your negotiation capability. But if you present a range, well, of course you would present a range. You haven't done your full analysis of running comps, looking at other properties in the neighborhood, and you haven't seen the property. So how do you know what the repairs are at that point? So of course you would have a range of what you could pay for the property given these different stipulations. So whenever you present a price point, especially in those beginning conversations, you want to give yourself a range, or you want to present a range, so you give yourself that flexibility that you can always fall back on as you do more due diligence. And as you do more due diligence and you have more and more conversations and you get closer to a definitive price, at that point, that's when you start talking specific numbers as you've run more of your calculations and due diligence in general. So when presenting a range, a great example would be something like this. You got a call from a prospective seller. You've had your initial conversation with them and you've already found out a little bit more of the details. This might be the first conversation or the second conversation. It should be the first one though. And you've presented a range. You're saying, for this house, I believe I can pay $40,000 to $45,000. Regardless if they say yes or no to this, your answer is going to be the same. If they say, okay, yeah, that sounds like a great option, then you say, well, that's great. This is just my initial due diligence numbers. This is just my initial thought process of the price point. I still need to go see the home and get an idea of the condition of the property. When can we schedule an appointment to view the property? And if they say no to that same price range, hey, we can pay $40,000 to $45,000 for this house, and they say, no, that price point won't work for me, well, then your answer is still the same. Hey, these are my initial numbers. I still haven't seen the property. I would like to go see the property and get a better idea of the condition of the property, and then I'll have a more accurate number of what I can present to you. But the answer is still the same. And of course, you would only go to the property if you're close on numbers. But what you don't want is you say, hey, I can pay $45,000 for this property. You go and look at the property and you find out they didn't really mention the foundation was a problem, or that the roof was leaking and they forgot to mention that. Or when you went over there, the condition was worse than you anticipated. So actually you need to be at $40,000 for this particular property. Well, if you told them $45,000 initially and you went and looked at it and now you need to be at $40,000, even though it's legitimate because the condition of the property is in worse condition than you anticipated, from the seller's perspective, it is a lot harder to go from $45,000 to $40,000 when you're negotiating with them. It's going to be a harder conversation and your chances of success have diminished. Now, if we simply change the initial conversation and said $40,000 to $45,000 for this property, a conservative range, when you go and look at the property and you assess that the repairs are more than you anticipated, and now you go to the seller and say, you know what, I need to be at $40,000, well, then this isn't a surprise for the seller. You've already told them from the beginning that it could be $40,000. But let's say the rehab was even worse than that, and you need to be at $37,000 or $38,000 to make this a reality. Well, you told them $40,000 to $45,000, so going from 40 to 37 is a small differential. You have a higher success rate of getting the seller to agree compared to 45 to 37 when you told them a strict 45 price from the beginning. So by having that range, it gives you the flexibility for future negotiations to increase your success in the long term. Because negotiation can happen in one conversation, but the reality is negotiation happens over the course of a series of conversations until you've both come to an agreement. So remember, use a price range to increase your chances of success.